Hello, my friends, and welcome back to The Morning Mindset. It is time for us to get our minds aligned with the truth of God. If you're new to The Morning Mindset, let me just tell you a little bit about it. My name is Kerry Green. I am retired as a pastor, but as you can see, continue to encourage people with the Word of God because I love the Word of God and I believe it brings truth to our lives. And The Morning Mindset is just my small little effort to help the Church of Jesus Christ across the globe be encouraged every day and equip itself for the work that he has at hand for us. If you want to find out more about The Morning Mindset, look at the podcast player that you're holding in your hand and look in the description of this episode and you'll find out more right there. Okay, we're looking at Psalm chapter 95. And I want to begin in verse 6. We covered 1 through 5 yesterday. And verse number 6 continues the same theme that we heard yesterday. It says, "Oh, come." So it's imploring us, "Oh, come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord, our Maker, for He is our God, and we are the people of His pasture and the sheep of His hand." Now let's stop there for a moment. There's plenty there for us to consider today. Let us bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord. Those are positions of humility, aren't they? They're positions of subservience where we submit ourselves to the one we're bowing to. Now, that's kind of an awkward thing for us to consider, isn't it? That we would bow, kneel before anyone, especially in the Western world. I mean, in certain parts of the world where there's a monarch, that may be regular practice. But here, in the United States, where I'm broadcasting this, man, that's kind of foreign to us because we're so steeped in the mindset and the language of freedom and individuality and being a rugged individual and having rights. But my friends, if I can say this as carefully as I know how, but still boldly, we really, as creatures before our Creator, have no rights. Stop and let that sink in for a minute. We have no rights compared to the great grace that's been poured out on us by our Creator. Because He is the one who has done everything for us. He is the one who has placed us into His family through Jesus Christ. He is the one who gives us life and breath and every blessing that we have in life. And therefore, we are obligated to worship and bow down, to kneel before the Lord, our Maker, because He is our God, and we are the sheep of His hand and the people of His pasture. You see, I think sometimes in our culture, we elevate ourselves and our own rights far too much, and it spills over into the church, and we become kind of offended if someone were to tell us we should bow or kneel before anyone, even God. And I wonder, the church where you fellowship, would it be an odd thing if the pastor or the worship leader were to direct the congregation in the practice of kneeling, actually physically kneeling in reverence to God and bowing before Him? It would feel a little uncomfortable in many churches because it's not something that's culturally done, that we kneel before anyone. But my friends, I think it might be a good thing for us just to hit pause on this recording the moment it's done. And for the sake of teaching, instructing our own hearts, physically bow, physically kneel before the Lord because He is our Maker. He is our God, and maybe that physical gesture would help us to reorient our hearts today. I'm going to do that as soon as I'm done recording here. I'm going to kneel before God and just stay there for a moment in His presence, realizing who He is compared to myself, and that I, of all people, am most blessed that I am able and called to bow before my King. Join me again tomorrow.